To close this wonderful conference, I want to thank everyone on behalf of Mount Sinai School of Medicine. It has been an enormous honor for us here at Mount Sinai to partner with MSF and DNDI to put on this conference. I was deeply moved by the stories of the terrible diseases, Kala-Azar, Chagas disease, the multiply and extremely drug-resistant TB, but also the stories of the new vaccines and the new medications that are coming along are cause for great hope. And I feel personally that I've been in the presence of heroes these 2 days, so I salute you all. There were three things that really struck me in this conference. The first was a comment that was made yesterday afternoon by Mr. Viehbacher, the CEO of Sanofi, who said that neglected diseases are diseases of poor people. I think that phrase just encapsulated the whole thing, hit it exactly square on the head. People that have no voice are the people that have neglected diseases. Mark LaFour said the other day, and again just now, he emphasized the importance of partnerships. In my own long years in public health, I've never seen anything that didn't succeed without partnerships. I spent a lot of my life working on the problem of childhood lead poisoning. In this country, childhood lead poisoning falls upon the poorest and most disadvantaged children in our society, children who absolutely have no voice. It was long a neglected disease. And the reason it became no longer a neglected disease and was largely controlled was we created broad-scale partnerships that spanned the society and involved governmental agencies at the highest level, made the prevention of lead poisoning a national priority, and we succeeded. We did the same thing 50, 60 years ago with polio. When polio ceased to be simply a disease of the poor, moved into the middle class, affected Franklin Delano Roosevelt, it became a national priority. The third big impression that came out of this conference built on those first two, and it was the remark, it was the smallest and probably the single most potent statement on the whole conference, the 30-second announcement by the young woman from the front row from the government of France announcing that at the highest level, France is imposing a new tax that will create funds for R&D against neglected diseases. That's a model, I think, for all countries and a source for enormous hope going forward. I hope it can be replicated and fed in. So I'm the next to the last thing between you and lunch. I simply want again to thank MSF, to thank DNDI, and to say that we would be delighted to host another conference in 5 or 10 years' time to mark the next milestone in this incredible journey. And now I'll turn it over to Dr. Tanner.
Thank you very much. Thank you very much, everybody. What should one add now? Everybody wants to have lunch and has to go to board meetings and so on. But I think it's for us, with DNDI, and a really great privilege that we could be together here. And it's a wonderful time that we can spend together in this gathering. Many have left, but many are still here. And it's very important that we could meet. And I start with this and say, I have no roots, no fruits. It was very good that we were reminded where we come from, the respect from where we come from, with the fatal imbalance. And I'm very happy that I've seen many of the founders at many levels that are still around, who has actually gone with us, made with us the journey. This was the driving force and remains the driving force. If it is called today lives in a balance, or if it's still a fatal imbalance, this remains. And I think this is something which has given us the joy also to pursue. DNDI is particularly thankful that we have had all the partners, and not just committees and working groups and experts, but all the partners that we actually could develop in a different way by really starting with the patients and closing with access the circle again where the patients' needs have to be fulfilled. So this is a big thank you that I say on behalf of all our colleagues of DNDI that we could do the journey, and particularly also to MSF, actually that was at the root of all this where we are today. We would not be, all of us, what we are today without having had this privilege to really work actively on this fatal imbalance. You see, it's good to celebrate because we can celebrate. And I would add to our dean another thing. It's not only that we have recognized we don't have to look at neglected diseases only, but at neglected people, but also at neglected systems, health and social systems. That is actually this important triangle where we have to see the patient's need and to have to move on. And this was very clear in many of the panels that we discussed today, that this triangle is the determinant. Of course, we are not happy that we have not moved quicker. We have made this 10 years analysis, and of course we have seen, and that's terrible and unacceptable, what we learn about the MDR situation and the TB situation. It's unacceptable what we see, that how few people are treated in Chagas disease. It is unacceptable that we're muddling through with the vaccines, and it is unacceptable that we have still an R&D landscape that is fragile. These are things which were clearly stated. I don't want to rehearse them, but just to take along, not just as a problem, but as a driving force that we move on and not just continue to have the same statements that we had 10 years ago. So it's good to celebrate, to bring up these issues. And it is very important now to think, what is the way forward? The way forward, and I think something which I dare to say, I hear too much, if I make my own summary, that we talk about problems. I think here is a group of people who has made a lot of the problem analysis. We know that we have to start with the patients. We know that we have to listen to many people. We know that acceptability matters. This is things we have learned already a long time ago. But what we need is not to learn why things can't work. That was, for instance, the discussion on the regulatory issues. We must find ways to show how things can work. And I think that is what I take along from this conference. I have heard too much of the problems and too little of how, in concrete terms, not in grand frameworks and so on, the things can work. And I think there are many things that, when we think of this impressive panel on Chagas, on the impressive panel on TB, I think here you see very many steps that we can actually start yesterday, and we can actually start moving. And all those down a lot with these solutions in these famous questions of roles and responsibilities. I have often said that in other circles, the problem that we have, that we are always together and we stay together, we analyze together, but we have very often not, and we don't do this exercise, don't worry, we have not enough analyzed what is exactly one's role and responsibility in drive an initiative and go forward. We are too superficial because we have all these superficial tools nowadays. So we are floating like rafts with no real keel going down and really moving ahead. It's not enough to talk about partnership, but it is really very important that when we get together, in each of these gatherings, we define much better what is the role and responsibility into carrying solutions forward. I think this is something which also helps to go to this delinkage for linkages at whatever linkages you want to have. This assessment at each organization, at each level where we are active, we make, helps us to come into this delinkage for better linkage and for progressing ahead. And so another important thing which I really very much liked in this conference was to really this emphasis on the full pipeline, not the segment of the pipeline, the section of discovery, the section of access, but really trying to start at the very beginning, that's the people, and at the very end where we go back to people. And that's why the important remark today, of course, it's not to market. In our field, it's really back to the people. And I think this is something which we learn, and we have to take home and think, where can we really live that actively? The other point, which we also saw in these roles and responsibility, has to do what each partner to take up. And it's not that now people from regulatory authorities are singled out. I could also take people, clinical trialists. Here, it is not sufficient, if we deal with the problems we deal, just to go the beaten tracks. And there are certainly ways, and there is a bad need that we do now really look at how we can go better in carrying much quicker products to the people. It is not only the question of the MDR, where I'm pretty sure there is a way forward that we can be much quicker, because this is our responsibility. But there's also a way forward in the way how we design our trials. We have shown over the past 20 years that we have found ways on speeding up trials. We have also found ways that even sometimes surrogate measures are accepted by regulatory authorities to be taken as a step forward. And on the other hand, we need to go for regional registration, because country by country, once you really reach it, this is an unacceptable long process. So here I see a lot which I put under the umbrella of roles and responsibility, where we have to rethink how we can speed up, not just shifting it left, right, and center, the responsibility. I think this is all that what we learned as a DNDi from our partners, not in working as DNDi alone, but from working with you. That has stimulated us to think about quicker ways on how we can move really products to people. And again, I mean, we don't like so much only the medical innovations are here. Innovations, in a way, as a product, there are many things that are already there and present that actually can be animated in a different way and can sometimes bridge. A very good discussion, which was too long, was the question of combination therapy in visceral leishmaniasis for quite some time. It's not to search for that product or the two products, the new ones, but use what we had and to bridge periods when we exactly know that we cannot be moving enough. So bringing all this together, it's a challenge for us of all to rethink in which position we can really make a contribution to be much faster, to be more effective, always for the populations concerned. Another thing, which is the whole convention on R&D, it's now not the convention, but it's not the point now of having long meetings on why we don't have a convention. The important meetings are now, and thinking is how we can move this process that we reach once a state where these things are better regulated, where we have actually the norms and the balances in order to really move ahead. So these are a few things, and this goes back then from the roles and responsibilities to the question of partnership. This has been mentioned many times, and I deliberately did not start with the partnership, because sometimes we use this as a buzzword, and everybody understands something different. That's why I started with the roles and responsibilities. We could start, thanks to the founder members and the founder spirits, DNDi as a PDP. And we are still a PDP, and this product development partnership at the time when we started was also called PPP. And then some people added PPPP because there was the population at the end, private-public partnership populations. We understand us all as a PDP, but for us, the first P are the patients. The Ds are actually squared, because this is develop and delivery. And the third one in our PDP understanding are the partners. And there we don't care so much that this must be private. It can be private. It just must be the partners that bring our products to the success. So I would like to think that we should all go away and really lift this PDP in this sense, that how we bring the people and the partners and the development together, and particularly also that we would think that such type of meetings, not necessarily in New York City, but this has also roots, that's why we are here, actually are the better meetings than just the committees and the expert groups that actually get this view of the full pipeline, how we really start with the patient, and we at the end go back to the patient. It's too long, 10 years. We should find better ways of having this iterative process on really working together. The final point, as some of you know very well, this is very often my final point. It's not always to talk about concern and what is difficult and complex. And if you want to do, it's not only, as we hear yesterday, about having brilliant minds. Of course we need brilliant minds. But what we basically need, and what I found is a tremendous privilege to be with you, is that one has enough enthusiasm, not only passion as an activist, but also enthusiasm and simple joy, joy to discover, joy to contribute, joy to share. And I think we should keep that, and we can still increase it, because that's really what brings the best product for our population, joy. And it was for us a real joy to be with you here, and I thank you all for all what you have actually contributed, how you lived through this conference. I hope this iterative process goes on and on, and much quicker. And now we are coming to the very special thanks that we have to give to people, because we would not sit here if we would not have really some cornerstones of the whole thing. We cannot mention all the names, but of course on the MSF side, people were working for months already to bring us here together. And Kevin Fallon, please. This is the man. And no. And Rachel. No, we are going first, Kevin. You know, so here's some ingredients for all the that we have for you, because you had to work very hard. And we are very grateful.
I share with everyone.
And now, where is Emily? Emily, where is Emily? Good old Emily, yes, here. Over. You also deserve. She is already there. So it's fine. But I also want to give you a kiss. Yes, thank you very much, Emily.
Thank you.
I have a second part. thank you very much. So these were the two people, besides many others, that contributed fantastically to all what we could do. We have also Nejin, Stephen, Hannah, from where I don't have now some ingredients, but that we will see. But you are also pearls of MSF who have contributed that we can be here. And of course, Mount Sinai School of Medicine, our Dean of Global Health with his team, and I must lead, is Niels and Elena, who were actually helping a lot to get this Niels here. And Elena, I don't know where she is, because I don't know her. Yes, but you see, and we thank really that we could be here, a wonderful place with interesting sound effects at the beginning. But everything very nice. Thank you so much. And then, of course, I thank, and this I cannot do now with persons, all my dear colleagues from DNDI. I mean, all the teams of DNDI, many not here, still working now in the field. Some are here, up to the executive team. You see, we started in the field. the executive team, and then the dear colleagues of the board members. So you see, it's a privilege to work with you. It's wonderful. Let's take this enthusiasm in our next steps of our work. Thank you very much, all, and enjoy lunch. And board members, agglutinate very soon at Madison Avenue. We have to work now. Thank you very much.